Hi everybody, this is Patty with A Soul's Heartbeat, and I'm here, and I've just been playing and hanging out in the craft room the last week, and I thought, well, maybe I'll do a video call and show you guys what I've been up to. You know, I've been organizing my laces. You know how it is, the first of the year you get this bug that you want to clean up, redo, reorganize, put things nice and tidy. So my laces, I'll have to look and see if I have a picture of the before. But they were in like three humongous baskets, and they've been sitting in our bedroom for months because I just didn't know what I wanted to do. Well, I'll show you. This is what I did. I have a corner cabinet that has six slots with these 10 by 10 baskets. And so I just took my 8.5 by 11 inch chipboard, cut it down to fit these, and then wrapped. I have two. One is white and colored, and then this is the ecru and the black, and then I have one that's just leftover pieces that weren't big enough to wrap. But that's just a side note, because that isn't what I wanted to show you. But in the course of doing that, you know how one thing leads to another. I found these tag thingy-ma-giggers that I had originally had wrapped my laces this way on, and you can see, I don't know, here, oh yeah, see all the little marky-doos on them, because I had stapled them with a little mini stapler, and I tossed them, and then I went and dug them back out. You know how bad we are, because I thought, well, you know, those are great, they're a nice shape, I should use those and make some tags. So I've been watching all these videos, just, you know, passing time and getting ideas from people. And I have been making these tags, and I thought, oh, I've got to make one and show you. Simple, simple process, nothing to it. But let's just take a tag, and I cut some paper strips. Where are they? Oh, here they are. I just have been going through my collections and picking out ones that all were kind of the same theme, because I don't know where these tags are going. I don't know whether they'll all be used in the same place, whether I'll be giving them away one at a time. If I ever got my Etsy store together, whether I'd be selling them. I don't know, but I found these two collections. They happen to both be old, old Graphic 45 ones. And I think I'm going to work with this one. I really like the print on this. So what I did is I have run out of my collage page, which I realize how much I love the collage page. That's an Eileen product, and if you haven't used it and you're anywhere near where they have it, pick it up and try it. I like the matte. Oh my goodness, I couldn't find it here. And you know, when you got a bee in your bonnet and you want to do something right now, you don't want to wait to order, and Amazon was so much more expensive that I ended up going to my local Joann's with a coupon, and I got Mod Podge. Well, now I know why I like the collage podge. I'm not as thrilled with the Mod Podge at all, but it's okay. It has served the purpose. So what I did was I took my tags, I went through my collections, I found colors that would work. I've been going through all kinds of drawers and oh, you know how you'll stick stuff back in a little container here or a little container there. So I've been going through everything and just using it up, seeing what I had that would work. Okay, so now I'm going to line this up on the one edge. So I only have to trim the other edge. And I really, really like it when you can file it away, and I'll show you. I have like seven of them finished, but I wanted to start this process with you first. And my one problem with the Mod Podge is that I get bubbles, and I do know that if I'm patient enough, that's a joke, people, patient enough to just let it sit for a while, that the bubbles go away. Or if I dry them with a heat gun. So then I'm just going to trim. And I watched somebody, geez, I've watched so many of you lately that I can't remember who it is. I can just hear her and see her, but I can't remember her name. Anyway, she never uses a ruler. She never uses a cutter. She just uses the scissors and just trims. And I think, oh, I wish I could do that. So I've been trying to convince myself it's okay if it's not perfect. I didn't realize, do you ever do anything and you don't realize how big a deal it is to you until you try not to do it? Well, that was my thing. Okay, so we got this one on pretty good. Isn't that pretty? That's going to make a gorgeous tag. So let's go ahead and do the other side. And so I went through, like I was saying, and I dug out old bins and totes and all kinds of stuff. And I also dug out my Tim Holtz people, you know, the paper dolls and the unclaimed relatives and all this jazz. Now, I didn't buy those because they just, to me, were so creepy. And I know you've heard me say this before, that I couldn't do it. But I had a couple friends who sent me some. And then my niece has been cleaning out her stuff. And she just gave me another package. And it was like, oh my goodness, now I have all these. I've got to use them. Oh my goodness, I think I'm in love. Now, I still haven't convinced myself to use the ones. I wish I had them here so I could show you. They're bigger. They're like a kind of like a mini postcard size. I just can't do it. I got them out again the other day and looked at them. And I thought, I just can't do this because I'm one of those lucky people. Well, lucky or cursed, I don't know what the word is. I have hundreds and hundreds of heritage folders. The on both sides of the family, on my in-law side and my mom and my dad's side, I have all these photos that have ended up in my possession. Well, these unclaimed relatives of Timmy, they look just like my unclaimed relatives. So I look at them and I think, oh, I just don't think I can use that. That's somebody's mom, dad, aunt, uncle. And the ones that were the photo booth ones, have you seen those? Those are like the little old photo booth. I can't talk and clamp that thing down at the same time. They're the long strips that have like four photos in them. And you put the quarter in or the nickel or whatever it was in the photo booth and it shot them out. For you youngsters, you'd have never seen one of those, I'm sure. But oldies and goodies like me, you know what I'm talking about. Well, those were really bad because some of them have written on them. I don't know where he got them from, but I just couldn't do it. So they're still sitting here and I'm trying to figure out someday they'll inspire me and I'll be okay. I'm trying to keep this over this. That's my Otlight and it shows up and has such a reflection. Okay, so now I have this great base to work with and it's sturdy because we actually have the cardboard in the middle and two layers. So with it, I went through and kind of played finding different things I had. If you follow my channel, do you remember back? I think it was last year that my niece brought me the really, really old scrapbook. And in it, these were the papers that were in the pages. And I had them in the garbage and then I pulled them back out because somebody said, no, you should use them. They're quite fragile, but like my niece said the other day, they're so naturally aged and stained and whatever. You could never get this effect yourself trying to coffee dye it or whatever. So I've been using them in places that won't get a lot of wear and tear, but can't get it back there. A lot of wear and tear, but will provide that vintage, really vintage feel. So I had this piece here and this was just a cut apart, but I left the edge on it. I cut another piece for the back like this. And let me show you what I'm going to do. I'm going to take some ink and I think this is a Graphic 45 Travelogue set. But, you know, if you do these, they're going to be so much different than yours because you'll be using whatever you have. And before I go any further, let's see, this is 8.5 by 3.5 approximately is the size that I'm working with of my postcard. Now you could have yours. Now a couple of them I cut down a little bit smaller, but it's going to be whatever size you have available to you, or what will work with if you have a project in mind you want to use them for. See, I don't know what I'm using them for. I'm just having fun making them. So I've inked all around my edges, and I'm going to glue. Let's see, what do I want for my back? I want this for the back because it matches that piece. I'm going to use my art glitter glue, and I'm just going to glue this to it. So now I'll have a little booklet, and then I'll show you what I'm going to put in the booklet if I can get the needle in the glue. Come on. There we go. Okay. So I'm going to put this, going to line it up with the edges there like that, and then just fold that over, and that makes my back piece. And now I have this nifty little booklet. Isn't that cool? So I took some of that antique paper, and see, you can see where stuff has been pulled. It didn't cut right. It tore. It has marks. I don't know if you can see the line here, and it was rough there and dark. That's okay. That's the whole purpose of this, is because it makes it antique-y. And I just cut it down. I had strips, so I just used what I had. And I have a little bitty, but I don't think this one's going to work because I don't think I can get in there with this one. I need a tiny attacher and I don't have it. So mine are going to be a little bit bigger, but that's okay. And I'm going to go in this way where, and it's right here on this line. And I think I'll put two. I'll put a staple here and I'll put a staple here and hope that I got, yeah, pretty close. Not right on, but close enough for what I want. So now I have this little travelogue booklet to go in one of the pockets on my tag. See? Cool. Like that. Well, that was not smart. I put the same on the front and the back. Duh. I didn't want to do that. Oh, well, that's okay. I wanted one on one side and one on the other, but that's what I get for talking. I cannot talk and work at the same time. But so many of you, when I made my 10 questions about me, that kind of stuff, said that you kind of like these videos where I just do the process with you and just play and let you be a part of my craft room while I'm doing it. Now I found these cool, these are shank buttons, but look at them. Aren't they cool? I don't know if you can see. They're like a little clock on there. They were in my stash, and they look pretty old. JHB International. I don't know. I think those are older antique ones. I have this. This was a tag that was in the paper line. So I just took my straight edge. I cut around this. I added a piece behind it and then another piece for the back. And when you flip it up, it says name, address, phone, like a luggage tag. And then I put that other little piece on it, and then I have a little world globe. Now this is gonna tie right here at the top, but we wanna put that on at the very last. I have this destination one that I'm gonna have to, oh, but I found this. See, this is a whole different paper line, but it doesn't matter. Don't worry about that because I'll show you. I'm gonna use this for a pocket, and I'm only gonna ink the three sides right now because I'm gonna have it go off. See, how far do I want it to go up? Because I want this to slide down in it. Maybe it might be too thick to slide down in it. I might have to use this for something else. But let's say we want it right about here. I'm going to stretch the top so that I get a nice curve on it, and I'm just going to go around the edge like this. And the one side is quite a bit below the other. See how I've only glued on this side and glued on that side? Because I want it to go about like that, so that it's not even. And then I'll show you, and then we'll ink. I don't know why I inked around those sides, because I'm gonna have to re-ink, but that's okay. I'm gonna trim the excess off, and then you'll get a better idea of what it's gonna look like. So when you guys are working on stuff and you have no end result in mind, you're just actually playing with your stash of stuff and using stuff up and just enjoying yourself, how do you do it? Do you do 40 of one all at one time assembly line, or are you like me and you do one at a time, finish it and then go on to the next one? I can't seem to like get this far on one and then do another one and another one, even though I knew I had 10 of these things. I had 10 when I started. I have to do each one and let it come to life and then do the next one. Okay, now see, now I have a nice pocket, but now to me that's too plain. So I have, where is it? I have this little strip like this that cut off, and I think I would like to put it across the bottom down here. Because to me, it's just that white spot is just too plain. This was just off the bottom of the paper. And this is going to be nothing just other than decoration. So I'm going to glue it right down like this. And then I'll just trim off the edges. This one. And this one. So do you do assembly style, or do you do one at a time? Doesn't matter, I'm just curious. You can leave me a comment and let me know how your creative process works. But I found this was kind of fun. I've worked on so many design teams for the last few years, and I've taken a break from them because I just kind of wanted to work with the stuff that was in my stash. Ooh, I like that. But because now this and this are the same, I need to back this with something so that, I wish I had my black right here. Okay, got to get a piece of black. I'll be right back. I'm going to have to glue this, and that's okay because it will make it stronger. I'm going to glue this onto a piece of black with just a skinny, minute little edge all the way around. Okay, and I've already lost, here it is, lost my pin. Okay, I've always worked on so many design teams for years now. And last year, I was just feeling kind of burnt out from everything. So I've really taken a step back because I just wanted some time to play and just use up some of the stuff I have in my stash. My goodness, people, do you have stuff like that too? I know you do, because you're all crafty junkies like me. That's a little bit close, but that's okay. It'll do. Let's see. Where is my... It'll do. I just need a little hint. Well, I don't know how much of that little oops moment I'll leave it in, but I just dump my water for my glue brush, and it went all over the place. I'm not good about having liquidy things near me because I go like this. Okay, so that kind of threw me, so I don't know where I'm at now. What I was saying, I wanted just this little hint of black around here so that it'll make it kind of pop out just a little bit from that background. We'll probably put some lace or something else there anyway. So I need my crocodile to cut, let's see, like that. for a tag. So that's pretty cute. And then I found this button too. And it, I don't know, I think this is a Prima button. I have no idea, but I think I'm gonna put it where the stamp is supposed to be. And I think I'm gonna use some Beacon 3-in-1 because I want something that's a little bit heavier to hold this in place like that. So anyway, so there, okay, I have that. I have this. And when I dumped my stuff over a minute ago, it kind of went all over the place. So I'm going to back it in black too, just so that it will pop. It's a little wrinkly from the water, but that's okay. It just gives it more, more interest. I wish I had a little piece of burlap here. That's what I need, is some burlap. So I may have to go hunting in my drawer. Now see, I'm only using the scissors. I'm not using my cutter. By the way, that cutter was a gift from my friend Cheryl at Christmas time, or my birthday. She told me I could have it for whichever one I wanted. And I love it. It's nice to have it right here on my desk. And my old Fisker one is the first thing I bought when I first started crafting or doing paper stuff. So it had been around for a long time. That's still a little crooked. See, this is what drives me crazy with cutting it on my own. But I'm trying to get myself over this idea that everything has to be perfect here. So I have that, and I have this little thing that says beach. And I just don't know. Maybe I'll cut this apart. I thought I was going to make it like a signpost. But let's cut it apart because I kind of like it here. Just as an added piece of interest. Like this. Maybe we'll have it hanging off too. So it's got a curved edge to it. I like things that hang off that aren't so straight edged. And let's do the ink here again. So I need to have you let me know, do you like these kind of videos, the ones where I just sit and chat and walk you through what I'm doing, or do you like the ones where I take everything out and speed it all up and and just do the talk over the top? Let me know so then I have a better idea of what I should do going forward. I really like this look. Now, this, of course, I don't know whether I want that. And see, I kind of did mine according to size here and put them in different envelopes. I think I kind of want this size, and we may have to put, I think I'll do that. This is going to have to go on the back part here, and I'm really, really still upset that I did this. I'm almost thinking that I would like to, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to put another layer on the back of it. Who cares? I'll be happier. Oh, need some more paper towel because I'm gonna Mod Podge another piece on it then, because I'm just not happy that I'm not happy that the front and the back are the same. I didn't want that, and I did it in air because I was talking to you. So let's see, let's put it this way. And what difference does it make? This paper has been sitting in the cupboard, hasn't been used. It's left over from what the project I had. So I'll just make this tag a little bit sturdier. So if you're not liking something, don't be afraid to cover it up. There are no paper police that are going to knock on your door and nab you because you used an extra piece of paper. Now, I may have some diehard fans that leave me a comment and say, oh, you're so wasteful. But that's okay. I can live with it. And don't laugh. I've had that happen before. It's funny, the things, the comments that people leave you. But, oh, I like this better. I just like that contrast, that the front and the back are not the same thing. Okay. Normally, I would let this sit back and dry for a while. But because you're on the other side of the screen here, I'm trying to do things. Now, just trying to move it back in place because it's really not dry. I'm forcing it. Ooh, I like that better. So now I have this part that was a leftover from here, and I'm going to put it, I don't know where I'm going to put it. I love this destination thing. I wanted to hang these on this side then, because see, they're going to show up a lot. Now see, that makes a nice part on the back of it. That's cool. Now I've got this hole here, and I did this one other time, and I'll show you. I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna push it through the hole here like that. We want the time at right spot at the top. Come on out of there. There we go. Let's see, where's our 12? There's our, I guess it doesn't matter. And then I'm just gonna take a little piece of, these are my scraps left over. Ooh, that's a good color. And anything that won't fit on a large panel goes in here to all my little pieces. I'm just going to push this through and tie it on this side through the shank. And I did this on another one too, and I really like it. Okay, that was a bugger. I edited it out because I didn't want you to see how long it took me to get that little sucker through that shank. But I'm just going to tie this on the back, and that's going to hold it in place now. But I'll give the clock on the front side, and I'll just give the bow on the back, which is perfect. And then this will finish out the back part. Okay, so we were gonna find some people. Maybe I'll put that destination in there after all. Let's find some people, something to go on this. I just love these people, I tell you. What do we have? Ooh, he's kind of cool. He could be standing on the beach sign there. But he doesn't look very beachy. These, he's too dressed up. Don't we have anybody that's not all dressed up here? Kind of like her. Isn't she cute? She could just be sitting on the edge. Let's do her. Okay, so I want to glue from her hands down like this, and her legs, and the rest of her will be free as a topper. So we want her to look like she's sitting right across the top right there. There we go. Isn't that cute? I tell you, these little people just make these.
What else do we have that we could put in here?
Oh, I have these. Let's see, travelogue. That's a great one. And I want some lace. So this is my scrap bin of lace. These are all the pieces that were too small to go across one of those boards. but we need some lace. I really like this. Do we want to put it at the bottom like this? Have it straight across? Have it like this. I don't know why, I just like things on the angle more. But I suppose let's do this one straight across. And just do the top like this, and because I'll have to trim it. So we're going to glue on three sides to make a pocket. Like this. Probably I won't, that won't work anyway, because let's see. Like that, down with the bottom. And this part is gonna have to be trimmed anyway, so that glue have to come off. I'm gonna stretch this a little bit so it'll give me a little bit more room in it. And we'll glue right along here this way and around the bottom like that. And let's trim this off. We have to finish this one up off camera, because I have so many other things I want to show you. Okay, so we have this lace, and I think I'm going to put it down here across the bottom. Do we want it up here on the top? Oh, I kind of like that too. I have some black, a little piece of black. I used it on one of the others. That one, but that's not. Oh, here it is. This is Anita stuff. This is sticky on the back. So let's use it like this. Oh yeah, that makes that pop. Pull it over a little bit more and trim it off. There we go. Like that. I have no idea where this came from. It was just something someone had given me at some time that was in my stash of stuff. Probably never get to the lace drawers with all this bits and pieces of lace that I have. Okay. Right. And now I want to use this piece. And this is like a cotton. I want it across the top like this. And let's use the 3-in-1, the beacons. Like this. And we're going to put this right here. Oh yeah, I like that look. Pull it down. Like that. Yep. And then I have this little tag that can go in there. Let's mount this on something. I have a manila tag. Let's just mount it on a manila tag. That would be good, because that'll give it extra stability then. Like this. Like that. Okie dokie. I think I'll save this. I might want that little piece here on something. So let's take the ink and ink around the edges. And I was looking for, I guess I could use another piece of this for my tie here on the tag. And then I want to find the background of this and just cut a little piece of it out. Let's go here like this. Like that. Come on. There we go. And pull it through. Cut a piece of this off like that. Okay. And this will just go up and through. And maybe we'll, because I have so much here, we'll tie this in a little bow. Oh, I like that. And now let's trim this. And I think I'm going to leave it hang just a tad over the edges like that. Okay. So now we have those. And we have this. But I wanted to get another piece.
I see this piece in here. And what's on the other side of this?
Now this probably isn't finished. I'm probably going to add more stuff to it. If I do, you'll see it in the
photos. Okay, so here's the rest of our tag.
I've decided I'm going to do two videos. This will be the process video, and then I'll have another one that will show you all of the tags. So I'm going to leave this one, and I'll pick it up on the next video, and we'll go through all of the tags that I've made so you can have ideas. This is the one we did on camera with a little girl. The tag. The button, the little booklet with the antique papers in it, the pocket with the beach sign, a butterfly, this sticky on tape, another tag, this mat back here. This is the shank tied down with some of the seam binding, and then a couple little hangy do's. Okay, so now I'll come back with the next video and I'll show you all of the finished ones I've done.